Next, I'm going to look at how that same application can now be written with the message passing programming model. Okay, so just as before, I have a main thread, okay, which is going to create n different threads again, and each thread is going to start by executing the procedure solve. Okay, and then you wait for these threads to end. So let's look at procedure solve. Okay, so each thread is going to do its own malloc and is going to create its own private space. Okay, so this private space is not going to be visible to the other threads. Okay, so again, if I take my matrix A, I've essentially partitioned it into these multiple pieces, and every thread is creating this own space for itself. Okay, and in addition to that, you're also going to create space for these neighboring rows, because even that is data that I need access to. Okay, but those rows are owned by your neighboring threads, but you still need to read those values. Okay, but I'm going to create a private copy of those rows in my own address space as well. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do, so as soon as I start, so I create the space, I initialize it, and then I get into my while loop. First thing I do is set my mydiff to 0 for this iteration. The diff is 0. And then I need to get the values of these elements over here and over here. So I send a message to my neighbors asking them to send me the most recent copies of those two rows. So I send a request to my previous thread, so PID minus 1, and a request to my next thread, PID plus 1, asking them to send me a row of data. And then I do a receive operation to receive those two rows from my neighbors. Okay, now that I have the latest copies of the data, I'm going to get into my for loops and do my averaging steps. I'm going to compute my mydiff. Okay, now I need to aggregate all of these mydiffs to have a global collective diff. Okay, so PID 0 is responsible for aggregating these diffs. Okay, so if I'm PID equals 0, then I get into this else part, and I receive everybody's mydiffs. Okay, and I receive it into a variable called temdiff, and I increment that temdiff to my own mydiff. Okay, so note that there's no lock over here, right? At one time, I'm going to receive one message. With that value, I'm going to increment mydiff. Then I go back and again receive another message, and so, since each receive operation is atomic, since I receive only one message at a time, I know that I'm going to do only one increment to mydiff at a time. Okay, so this is what PID 0 does. All the other PIDs are essentially sending their mydiffs to PID 0, and after that they'll wait until they receive the global diff value from PID 0. Okay, so ultimately when you're done, you check to see or at least thread 0 checks to see if the total diff value is less than the threshold. Accordingly, the value of done is then sent to all of these other threads that are waiting for it. Okay, so all of this is being done by PID 0. Whereas all of this is being done by the other PIDs. Okay, so there's no centralized piece of data, or there's no centralized pool of memory where you can read the values of the diffs and where you can increment the values of diffs. One single master thread has been assigned to compute the values of diffs, so you have to send values to that master thread. The master thread receives the values, does the increments, and then sends back the result to everybody else, right? So your program is full of these sends and receives, and the programmer is responsible for all of this explicit communication of data. Okay, so it perhaps makes the programmer's task a little bit harder, but it's perhaps pretty easy to produce a working version of this piece of code, right? I showed you earlier that there are complexities because of the locks and because of the barriers. Here, the code is perhaps a little bit more straightforward, and the synchronization is perhaps a little bit more explicit, and it's being done with these sends and receives. Okay, so for the most part, people believe that shared memory is perhaps easier to program in because it puts a smaller burden on the programmers. But there is synchronization that one has to grapple with, whether it is message passing or shared memory. And, just writing a parallel program is a difficult process, okay? And, that's not going to go away, okay? But, message passing is also known to have higher performance in some settings. So especially in the high-performance computing domain, message passing is much more popular because programmers are willing to invest the effort that it takes to write a program like this. But these programs can be tuned to give you extremely high and very predictable performance. Okay, so in the high-performance computing domain, where you don't care as much about programmer effort, but all you care about is performance, its message passing model ends up being very popular.